My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda, and this is the Introduction to Premiere Pro Lesson 2. This lesson is all about setting up Premiere Pro, its projects and sequences to get started with editing. This is part 2 in a 10-part series of free classes that I'm giving away. I am an Adobe certified instructor based out of Milwaukee. So if you have never launched Premiere Pro before, there's a couple different ways to do it. I am on the Mac. However, it's going to be fairly similar with Windows. You can just go to your files and your applications and launch Premiere Pro. And so what that's going to look like is if I go into my applications here, and we have our Adobe Premiere Pro, and I'm going to double click my icon here. Otherwise, I've got a little shortcut. So go ahead and launch Premiere Pro. Depending on which version you have, you may have a different splash screen. I am running 2015.3, which is released in late 2016. So their naming conventions are doing excellent this year. And I've got this little splash screen here. And when you launch it for the very first time, this is the screen that you're going to get. So this is our new project screen. This should look fairly similar depending on which version you have. If you are in the newest version as of 2016, you'll have another tab here that says Ingest Settings, but we'll get to that in a minute. Let's talk about what this new project window means. When you create a project that is a sandbox in which all your media is going to be stored or referenced, so it's a good idea to name your project whatever the project is going to be. If this was a commercial for a restaurant, you might want to put in the name of restaurant. Or if this was a commercial, you might want to put in the commercial and the client's name, etc. The next thing is going to be where this is going to be stored. This is pretty important, and let's talk about this really quick. Depending on where you store this is where it's going to access and reference your media. So right now I just have it stored onto my desktop, and that will show up in this corner here in a little bit. The next thing that we have here is our renderer. You may or may not have a drop-down window here. This is how it is going to render your footage. If you have specific video cards, such as the OpenCL cards or the OpenGL cards, namely some NVIDIA cards and select AMD cards, you will have a drop down here which will say CUDA or OpenGL or OpenCL depending on that. Because I don't have one of those specific graphic processing unit cards, I am only stuck with the Mercury Playback Engine software only. If you have options down here, you absolutely want to pick either your CUDA or your OpenCL. Depending on your machine, you're probably only going to have one or the other. And what that is going to do is it's going to leverage the power of your video card to speed up your renders. Highly recommended. The next dropdown we have here is our display format. 99 times out of 100, you'll probably be working with timecode. We do, however, have feet and frames depending on if this is actually going to go to print. The reason why we have feet and frames is, well, there's a physical cost to printing film either on 16mm or 35mm film stock. It is a great idea to know exactly how many feet that you're going to have to process for your production. Lastly, we have frames here, and that's typically if you're doing animation. So if I was working with a lot of After Effects projects in Premiere Pro, I might want to switch it to frames so I know which specific frame I'm working on. For our purposes, we're always going to stick with timecode in this lesson plan. In our audio, we have two different options here. We have milliseconds or audio samples. If I pick milliseconds, that means that I'm going to have 1,000 specific points in my audio format. However, I'm going to be working with 44 kilohertz sound, which really means 44,000 samples per second. So I'm going to go ahead and pick audio samples so I have much more of a gamut to choose from. Our last section down here is our capture format. Now, capture formats are specifically for if you're converting things from a tape-based media. So things like mini DV, full-size DV, etc., if that's going to be coming in as DV or HDV. Most of you are probably going to be importing from file-based media like memory cards or other hard drives. So this won't really matter unless you have a specific camera that has DV or HDV footage. Let's talk about scratch discs. What exactly is a scratch disc? Every time we create something in Premiere Pro that needs to be rendered, those renders are brand new frames that need to be written onto a disc. Most editors are going to have external drives connected to their machines to store and access their media. Video tends to take up a lot of space very, very quickly, and having it on the same machine as your operating system can really slow things down. As an example here, I have several different disks connected to my computer here. So I've got a RAID device of 5 terabytes that is mirrored. I also have a second hard drive for other projects that's 4 terabytes. And I have a couple other 5 terabyte hard drives that I connect depending on what I'm working on. So at any given point, I'm usually working with about 10 terabytes of media to store things. What this is asking us here is any captured video, captured audio, and that's from a DV or HDV device, any video previews or audio previews, those are our render files, and our project autosave and our libraries are all going to be stored in a specific area. Notice some of them say same as project, some of them say document. What I want us to do is put everything as same as project. You'll notice that right now it's telling me that on my hard drive here for my computer, I have exactly 975 gigabytes of space here. That's not a whole lot, but for our purposes right now, that's going to be plenty. If you're on the newest version of Creative Cloud 2016 or version 2015.3 or 2015.4, you'll have an ingest settings. This is a more of an advanced workflow. So for our purposes right now, we're going to ignore this. But if you're looking for more information on this, I will have future lessons talking specifically about this and why or why you may not want to use it. We're going to call this project and sequences. I don't want to put it directly onto my desktop, but I want to make a folder here on my desktop that's just going to be called lesson 2. So there I have lesson 2, and my project and sequences is going to go inside there. So I'm going to hit OK. And that's going to take me to the same window that we've seen before. So we just have empty windows here with nothing going on in here. If I minimize this here really quick, in my lesson 2 folder now, I have projects and sequences PR, PROJ. So this is our Adobe Premiere Pro project. And we're going to go ahead and open that back up. So that's the basics of setting up projects in Adobe Premiere Pro. In the next lesson, we're going to be taking a good look at setting up sequences and making timelines.